Hello, everybody, and welcome to Kid City Online. We are excited that you're here this week. We love having you come every week, but we would love to see you live and in person. We're having two services, one at 8:30 and one at 10:30. So we'd love to see you come. Everything is being safe and sanitized. We're wearing masks, keeping our distance, doing air high fives. But until you're ready to come back, we're going to continue to be here online. This week is another amazing lesson about being big and strong. We're going to continue in this series, but before we get started, get your hands up, get you some wiggle room. We're going to worship God today, okay? Get ready.
Because the Bible tells me to. I obey because I love God. I obey because I love my mom and dad. I read my Bible.
You need to get your parents up next time we worship. I forgot to ask you to do that. Next time, get your parents in there with you and worship, okay? You don't have to worry about nothing. You're at home. No one's going to see you. The neighbors aren't going to yell. Just get up and worship God with all you got. Now, we're going into our lesson. It's an exciting lesson. It involves some fire, some wood, some rocks. That's all I'm going to say. Let's get ready. Are you ready? Into the Bible lesson.
Slapstick Theater. Elijah on Mount Carmel. This is Elijah.
Heyo!
Elijah was a prophet in Israel during the reign of King Ahab. His job was to tell people what God wanted them to hear. This is King Ahab.
Whatever.
He came from a line of kings who did bad things, but King Ahab was the worst of them all. He led the Israelites to do evil things as well, and they turned away from God and started worshiping a fake god called Baal. God told Elijah to go speak with Ahab. Elijah told Ahab to bring all of Israel and the prophets of Baal to join him on Mount Carmel. So Ahab did as Elijah asked. Then Elijah stood in front of them and said, "If the Lord is God, follow him. But if Baal is God, then follow him." But the people were completely silent. Elijah called for two bulls and told the prophets of Baal that they could choose the one they wanted to sacrifice to Baal. They could put it on the altar, but not set fire to it. Elijah said, "I will prepare the other bull and lay it on the wood on the altar, but not set fire to it. Then call on the name of your God, and I will call on the name of the Lord. The God who answers by setting fire to the wood is the true God." And all the people agreed.
Yeah!
Elijah let the prophets of Baal go first.
All right, you first.
They prepared the sacrifice and called on the name of Baal from morning till noontime, shouting, "Oh Baal, answer us!" But there was no reply of any kind.
Hey!
Elijah began mocking them. "You'll have to shout louder. Perhaps he is away on a trip, or is asleep and needs to be wakened." So they shouted louder and raved all afternoon until the evening. But still there was no sound, no reply, no response.
"Everyone come here."
Then Elijah called to the people. They all crowded around him as he repaired the altar of God that had been torn down and dug a trench around the altar. Then he had some men pour water on the altar 3 times. Elijah walked up to the altar and prayed, "God, prove today that you are God in Israel and that I am your servant. Answer me so these people will know that you are God and that you have brought them back to yourself." Immediately, the fire of the Lord flashed down from heaven and burned up the sacrifice, the wood, the stones, and the dust. It even licked up all the water in the trench. And when all the people saw it, they fell face down on the ground and cried out, "The Lord, He is God. Yes, the Lord is God."
Man, that was awesome. I was sitting here watching it and I was like thinking, I'm waiting for something. What am I waiting for?
I don't know. Something amazing, I guess.
It was great. Elijah had the faith and the strength to pray to God to bring fire down from heaven. All those prophets of Baal, they didn't know what was going on. God is big and strong, and you can be big and strong too. Now, one of my favorite segments is coming up. My buddy Greg. Greg, you got everything prepared over there? You ready? We're gonna go. What do you mean you're not ready? He's almost ready. My buddy Greg is gonna take over and finish this lesson. You guys love him, I know, he's crazy. He's getting big and strong too. He's ready. Okay, over to you, Greg.
Hey, everybody. I'm Greg, and this is Big and Strong. For the last few years, I've been lazy. I've been sitting on my couch, eating junk food, and playing video games. But today is a new day. All the hard work starts here, going to the gym. So follow me, Greg, and my cameraman, Dan, as we start this incredible transformation. Come on, Dan. We're going to the gym. Big and strong. Big and strong. Come on, Dan! Alright friends, so today is leg day, which means it's time to feel the burn. And thanks to Dan, he lent me a pair of his virtual reality goggles. Now, what does virtual reality have to do with getting a good leg workout? Well, everything. These guys are gonna give me different scenarios to work out my calves, my glutes, my quads, my hamstrings, my glutes, my calves, my quads, and my quads, and my hamstrings. Now, we gotta dive into the virtual world, Dan, see what type of workouts we got going for us. Whoa. Oh, Dan, okay. All right, Dan. Way harder than I thought here. I think it's got us in some sort of cage or something. Okay, all right. Oh, all right, workout number one. Let's go. Whoa, Dan, we're hitting the jumps, whoa! Dan, we're surfing. We're getting a good core workout. Whoa, Dan, we're hang gliding. Up here. Hey everybody, welcome back. I'm hanging out with my dietitian, Billy. Billy, welcome back.
Greg, it's great to see you, man.
It's been a long time.
You know, you've made a lot of progress. You've cut out soda, sugary cereals, and fast food consumption.
Bill, to be completely honest with you, I don't even miss any of it, really.
None of it at all? Awesome. So you're eating lots of fruits and vegetables then, right?
No. I haven't had a vegetable actually in 4 years.
Really, that's been a long time. You know, honestly, your body needs really good vegetables and greens every single day in order to operate at its maximum capacity. So right here we have a greens drink. So
there are vegetables in
the shake. So this is gonna have spirulina, barley, wheat, wheatgrass, alfalfa, and all those hardcore vegetables that are really high in, you know, minerals and vitamins to help get you through your day.
And you know, guys, Billy was actually teaching me this the other day. Vegetables actually grow in the ground. I just learned that. It's like a plant.
Right. So basically, you're going to be able to eat these vegetables. It's going to give your body antioxidants to, you know, fight off disease. This is something that you're going to be able to do every single day just to kind of help your overall health.
Good,
check that out.
All right. That's the thing, Billy, is that this all sounds really good and cool what you're talking about, but this is kind of scary.
But, you know, I want you to be really, you know, brave here. You know, go out on a limb and do something that's good for your body.
Okay. Ooh, that's actually not bad.
So by drinking something like this, you know, eating, you know, better food choices and exercising every day, you're gonna build up a really good discipline and obedience, so that way your body's able to feel better each and every day, and you might actually even like the taste of vegetables.
Billy, I'm telling you, I think I believe you, and this stuff is good. I should have believed him before. I just had to be brave. Thank you.
Talk about, Greg.
Let's go get some veggies, huh?
Let's do it. You know, maybe like not even start out with hardcore like spinach and stuff, but how about some carrots?
Carrots sound good. They're like they look like a Cheeto, right?
They look like it, but totally different.
Perfect. There's probably a drive-thru, right? We get like a fast food
drive-thru. There's a place called the produce section at the grocery store. You know, we can go there and you can go ahead and shop and find some good healthy vegetables.
So we gotta go to the store to get the...
So I just got my carrot from the drive-thru. These things are pretty good. We're gonna head back to the nutrition store. Let's go, Dan.
All right, so I just got back from getting carrots for the first time, and they are really, really good. They're like the same color of my shirt. They're orange like Cheetos, but you don't get any dust on your fingers. It's like the perfect food. And Dan, you liked them. Dan liked them too, so I think you guys should try carrots. They're really good. But Billy's advice, they really got me thinking. In a sea of man-made junk food, we still have healthy, natural alternatives like carrots. And God's given them to us. No matter what the world offers, God always has something better for us. In the Bible, Ahab, the king of Israel, rebelled against God, choosing to worship Baal, a false god. Now, God sent his prophet Elijah to teach Ahab a lesson. Elijah put Ahab's false god to the test. They would see who was more powerful, God or Baal. They went up to a mountain and built an altar. Now, Elijah let the priests of Baal go first. They called to Baal and asked him to light the altar on fire. This went on for hours and hours, but nothing happened because Baal wasn't real. During all this, Elijah poked fun at the priest, telling him that they would have to shout louder if Baal was going to hear them. Finally, it was Elijah's turn. He decided to add an extra challenge. Elijah ordered the priest to soak the altar with water. When this was done, Elijah called upon God, and instantly, fire shot down from the sky like a bolt of lightning. The altar was engulfed in flames. And immediately, everyone knew that the God of Elijah was the true God. God will always be wiser and more powerful than anything else in the world. Sometimes we might be the only one following him, just like Elijah, but that shouldn't discourage us. When we're surrounded by other people who live in ways that aren't pleasing to God, it's tempting to want to do the same thing. But just like how our bodies want us to be healthy, our souls ultimately want us to be obedient to God. It can be difficult from healthy disciplines like praying and reading your Bible, but the more you do it, the happier and healthier you'll feel. Just like working out, it took time. Now, eventually, people will notice the difference in us, and they'll wonder where it comes from. By obeying God, we can be a witness to other people, showing them a better way to live. Because we believe in such a powerful God who loves us, we can go through life courageously, knowing that God's way is better than any other way. Now, Elijah had complete confidence in God, and you can too. Now, that's all I've got for you guys today. Thank you for joining me on my fitness journey. I think I've made a big change, and a big shout out to my cameraman, Dan, for coming along with me for the ride. I'm gonna keep working out and staying healthy, but more importantly, I'm gonna do my best to keep living courageously and living for God. And I think you guys can too. Remember, be encouraged and get motivated. We'll see you guys out there. Greg is hilarious, but he is trusting in God and he's believing and he's getting big and strong. You can too. Let's test your knowledge, okay? Let's go to our quiz right now.
For thousands of years, people have looked up to the stars and wondered what's beyond. Thoughts of distant galaxies, strange planets, and possibly even life unlike any we've known on Earth. But no one could have ever imagined in the deep expanse of our universe lives one furry creature with four legs and a jetpack. Bah. His name is Space Ghost, and he's here to help you, and he's here to help us, here to help us answer life's toughest questions. How did Elijah prove that the Lord was the true God? Was it A, he called upon God to start a fire? Was it B, he Googled it? Or was it C, he yelled louder than the others? That is correct. Elijah proved that the Lord was the true God by calling upon him to start a fire. Great job, cadets. How many false prophets was Elijah up against? Was it A, 2? Was it B, 700? Or was it C, 450? That is correct. Elijah was up against 450 false prophets. Well done, cadets. Why can we live courageously? Is it A, because God is powerful and he loves us? Is it B, because we eat tacos? Or is it C, because we get good grades? Well done, everyone. We can live courageously because God is powerful and he loves us. Well done, cadets. Until next time, stay spacey, cadets.
You guys did great on that quiz. That was amazing, I ain't gonna lie. There was a couple of them that I was stumbling on. But let's talk. We've had a great time today. This is an amazing lesson on being big and strong. No matter how little you are or how insignificant you might feel, with God, you can be big and strong. We have been learning in this whole series how God shows up every time, and he will show up for you too. Every situation that you're going through, you don't have to worry that you're not big enough, because with God, you are. Now, we're gonna leave. I want you to come back to church if you can. If not, we're going to have another lesson next week online. But let me pray real quick with you. Father, we thank you for this lesson on Big and Strong. Lord, we pray that you would be with everybody that's watching it. I pray that they be encouraged, Lord, to know that you are a big God. There is nothing bigger. Lord, we just love you and we just worship you with all we got. It is in Jesus' name. And everybody out there say, amen. All right. So can't wait to see you next week. God bless.